This video is sponsored by and dedicated to, wait for it, Mr. Ray's class. My greatest fans, or so they tell me. So let's assume that you're one of these lucky guys who has access to organic, locally grown tomatoes. The carbon footprint of this sucker is like hamster sized. If you take an organic, locally grown tomato and you put it somewhere, then that's its position at that moment. So I could put a little dot right there and say, that's the initial position of my organic, locally grown tomato. And if I move my organic, locally grown tomato to over here, then I might call that the final location of my organic, locally grown tomato. So I can talk about my organic, locally grown tomato moving from place to place using this language here of position. I probably want to specify it in terms of a location, maybe on a number line or something, that would help. But let me define something called displacement first. And I was thinking, displacement, that placement? No, displacement over here. Displacement is xf minus xi. They told you that the shortest distance between two points is a straight line. So let's make a straight line between those two points. I guess that is the displacement of the organic, locally grown tomato. But what if my what if it had done this? Spiraled outward more and more and more until finally landing right there. Would you say that the tomato moved this much distance? No, that's nuts. If you put an odometer on your tomato, I don't really recommend that you do this, but what if you have a little odometer on this sucker and it says 0.0 meters, and then you're hoping, you're really hoping that I built this into the tomato, right? As it scrolls, that number will go larger and larger and larger as the tomato drives around. So just like in Ferris Bueller's Day Off, you can't ever go back on the odometer. Once it's been driven a certain distance, it just maintains that distance. So if I did this, I would have a much larger reading on the organic, locally grown tomatoes odometer than just the displacement. The end minus the beginning would tell me about. In physics, though, we're really often interested in this concept of displacement. In fact, displacement gives us something called velocity. And I'm gonna say velocity, first of all, velocity is a vector and so is displacement. But velocity's definition, let me be careful to say this is average velocity. Well, that's going to be where you, let's call it delta x, first of all, divided by delta t. So that's that definition right there, plugged the heck in. And let's see, first of all, what could displacement do? Let me give you an example. It's probably really useful before we start doing displacement to talk about a number line. So here's our number line, and you grew up with these things, right? You're like, zero's there, super important, right? We define zero, and we also have to say which way is positive. So in this case, I've said that way is positive, and maybe this is one, and that's two, and that's three. So that means, wait, are you guys in fifth grade yet? Do you know about negative numbers? There you go, there's the negative one. Check this out. If the tomato starts at one, then I can call that xi, I'm gonna label xi equals 1 meter, and this is position in meters. If the tomato starts at one and goes to three, then I can say its displacement is, check it out, delta x equals, well, it's gonna be 3 meters minus 1 meter, which is 2 meters. Anybody interested in that? Great, that's fine. What if instead I start at a position of 2, xi equals 2 meters, and I go to 3 meters, and then I go to negative 1 meter. Did you see that? I'm starting at 2, going to 3, and ending up at negative 1. xf is what? Is it 3 or is it negative 1? Well, I guess I would say that it is negative 1 meters right there. Now, let's do the odometer thing. The total distance traveled for the organic, locally grown tomato is 1 meter so far, and then another 1, 2, 3, 4 meters. Dang, the distance traveled by the tomato is 4 meters. But let's figure out what the, wait, is it four? No, it's five, holy cow. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 meters is the distance traveled by the organic, locally grown tomato in this situation right here. But the displacement is much smaller. In fact, whoa, the displacement is going to be x final minus x initial, which is simply, oh dang, it's negative 1 meters minus 2 meters. That's negative 3 meters. So it must have moved the wrong way. Who's to say which way is the wrong way? Why do you think this way is the wrong way? It's because I set up that way as positive. So if you're moving the negative direction, I don't care which way you're looking. I don't care if you're doing a Michael Jackson moonwalk. If you're going the positive direction, you've got positive displacement if you just go in the positive direction. If you're going the negative direction, then you're getting negative displacement as time goes on. And the same can be said for average velocity. If your average velocity is that direction, then it's positive. Oh, that's my ray gun turning back off again. If your average velocity is that direction, then it's negative. And we don't have to have this number line pointing that direction. We could get pink out. No, it's too similar. Let's go blue. And we could say that is the positive direction, and that's the origin. And this could be 1 meter, 2 meter, 3 meter, 3 meter. And which way would you go to get a negative displacement? I guess you could start right here, for instance, and end up right there. This could be xi, that could be xf, and the displacement would be -1 meter. Who cares? You get to set it up. And let me give you a quick little graph. This will be pretty fun. We know the definition of average velocity. Average velocity is delta x over delta t. And I just wanted to show this graph. This is x as a function of time for a penguin that has been wound up. And I have to pretend this is a penguin. Here, this guy right here will be a penguin. I wound it up and it went across the screen. So then the penguin ends up over there. And I said it started at 1 meter, so here's my number line. And the penguin was actually moving from here, 1 meter, to 2 meters, 3 meters, 4 meters, etc. So I'm gonna make a graph. Well, how do you think I should make a graph? See if you can figure that out. I think I'm gonna make a graph that is sloped upward with a steady slope, because the penguin just went. So here's my plan. I'm gonna say that the xi is right there. Xi is that initial moment right there, and this is also the initial time, ti right there. And xf, maybe I stopped looking right here, I got disinterested, it's about to leave the page, I don't really care after that. That's going to be the final location, and the final location happened at something that I'll call the final time, t final. Now we need to investigate two things. We need to investigate rise and run, because I'm interested in a concept of slope. Slope is rise over run, and let's find out what that slope might be in this instance right here. I'm gonna take this guy over so you've got a little bit more room. I wanna do a dotted line here, and I wanna cross out this other dotted line and start writing in green. Now I know the rise is this distance here. That is, well, it's the difference between here and there. That's going to be xf minus xi. And the run, well, shoot, the run is right here, which is going to be t final minus t initial. Did I tell you about delta? Delta something, delta t for instance, that's defined to be the final of the thing minus the initial of the thing. So if I continue in this discussion where slope is rise over run, I'm gonna say it's x final minus x initial divided by t final minus t initial. Oh dang, you see where I'm going with this? You see where I'm going? X final minus x initial is delta t, and t final minus t initial, whoa, how could it be delta t? X final minus x initial is delta x, t final minus t initial is delta t. The slope is delta x over delta t. Guess what else is delta x over delta t? Delta x over delta t is also the average velocity. So we can say that the slope of a position versus time graph is the average velocity. Check it out. Okay, fine. I know you were waiting for this.